Hi everyone, these two next videos for EA365, my daily astrological series, are gonna be focused on what is called in astrology, the lunar nodes. Episode 4 is gonna be centered around what is called the south node of the moon. And the fifth episode is gonna be centered around what's called the north node of the moon. And to begin, I'm going to give you a little bit of a brief explanation as to the astronomical information and background, like the actual astronomy behind the lunar nodes and what they actually represent, just objectively speaking. And then give you an explanation, some interpretations as to the metaphysical, spiritual meaning that we as humans have assigned to the movements of the lunar nodes. So let's start off with the astronomical meaning behind the lunar nodes. So astronomically speaking, the lunar nodes correlate to the movements of the moon, her upward north node and downward south node movements. So just as the Earth revolves around the sun and it has this tilted axis, so it, you know, sometimes it orbits around the sun above the ecliptic and sometimes it orbits around the sun below the ecliptic, so does the moon also orbit around the Earth, you know, sometimes above the ecliptic and sometimes below the ecliptic. And just like when the Earth crosses that intersection of the ecliptic from below to above the ecliptic, we have spring equinox, a beginning of a new cycle, so does the moon go from below the ecliptic to crossing the ecliptic to being above the ecliptic, and that intersection is called the north node. And then just like the sun goes from the above the ecliptic to below the ecliptic and intersects this ecliptic at the autumn equinox on the 20th of September usually, so does the moon go from orbiting around the Earth from above the ecliptic to below the ecliptic and intersects that ecliptic. And at that point, we have the south node. The thing about these lunar node movements and points and polarities is that they have an 18.4 cycle. So every 18.4 years, the lunar nodes, wherever the south node and the north node were placed at your place of birth, at your time of birth, will return back to that point. In a way, in their own way, this is an ending of a chapter and a beginning of a new in our own karmic and evolutionary development, and more on that later. So that's objectively, astronomically speaking, what the lunar nodes refer to. Just like the Earth has this upward movement, you know, towards the spring equinox, and this downward movement towards the autumn equinox, so does, you know, that has to do with its relation with the sun and its orbit around the sun and this ecliptic plane, so does the moon and her movement around the Earth correlate, you know, to this upward movement, the north node, and the south movement, the south node. So I hope that's not too confusing, but basically the idea is, imagine that the moon ebbs and flows. She's pulled up, she's pulled down, but she's always orbiting around the Earth, right? That upward movement to go upward, to go northern, to go that quite literally north is the north node. That downward movement, that polar opposite end pulling it down, is the south node. The signs that those are placed within signify the energy that those two polarities are colored by. And like I said earlier, these lunar nodes actually move retrograde backwards around the ecliptic and return to the same placement and complete a cycle every 18.4 years. So this is something good to know in terms of your own natal chart and your own lunar charts. Every 18.4 years, the lunar nodes return to the same placement as the placement of your birth. And this, in their own way, in its own way, refers to and correlates to an ending and a beginning of a new karmic and evolutionary chapter in our own lives.